quickest, cheaper, and agile. Yes. See, Arduino did two things to two people. For computer science people, it eliminated the need to know electronics, the core of electronics. For electronics people, it made them to use programming easy. So if you want to use Arduino, you don't need to have code depth in programming, you don't have code depth in electronics. All you need to do was, you need to know was, use this command, this will happen. Simple. Now that's what made Arduino reach this much. Because some 10 years back, the whole embedded field was like closed, not open. People, so-called scientists, were working on embedded systems. What we are programming now. What we do now, those people, if you're doing it some 10 years back, you'll be called a scientist. Okay? So it is almost closed. Only when Arduino came into play, many people got into this embedded system. Even people from civil or mechanical, they started jumping into it because of its easiness, because of its open source thing. People started duplicating it, replicating it. Many ideas were coming into it. Now you know that one is open source, right? So when it's open source, people can modify it in a better way they want. So since Arduino was made open source, all these people who were away from electronics and computer science, they started jumping into it. Now Arduino is a highly supported community in the world. Okay, so it's Arduino is a revolution, I would say. Now that's why we have to celebrate this day. Okay, we have 400 events across the globe now, and mostly, most of them have workshops. I don't know what happened from the morning. I missed most of the fun part here. Okay, so you must have had some hands-on training, right? And Arduino, good. I'll speak about IoT a bit, okay? Because IoT is the trend, and it's going to be the trend. Okay, so what is IoT? Let me start with a very basic question. What is IoT? Yeah, I know it is Internet of Things. So, what do we do with IoT? You connect things together, right? You connect things together. What do you achieve by connecting things together?
Smart.
Remote access.
Smartness.
That's the word. Intelligence.
Laziness.
Laziness. Intelligence and laziness. Okay, which comes first?
Laziness.
No. Is that so? Because you become lazy, you become intelligent. No. It's the other way, right?
We are pushing intelligence to the devices and becoming
making us yeah, lazy. Yeah.
So you make someone else intelligent, you become lazy. Right? Right. So intelligence is the main concern of IoT, main objective of IoT. Okay, because when things get connected together, they started talking to each other. Right? I used to give this example to everyone. Let's say I have a mic in my hand. I have a mic in my hand. How many of you here before have heard this example before? You must have heard. Now you were here before this. Okay, let's say I have a mic in my hand. I speak. What does the mic do basically? What does it do? Amplifies it. So I speak something, it amplifies it and gives it to the speaker. Now I scold someone very badly. Will that be heard too? I scold someone very badly. Will you hear that? From the speaker? Will you hear or not?
Yes.
Yes, you'll hear that.
Yes.
What if you praise someone? Even that will be heard.
Yes.
Now I'm going to do something to this mic. After doing that, this mic will filter out all the bad words. Like if I say something bad, it will send a beep. Let's say. It will send a beep. Okay? If you say something good, we'll send it out. How can I do this? First thing I should have a text-to-speech converter. Okay, I'll have a text-to-speech converter. ICs are available. You buy that, you put it inside the mic. Then you should have a whole database full of bad words. Okay? You should have a whole database full of bad words. If the bad words are very less, they can be in the chip itself. They can be inside the mic. Let's say you have billions of bad words. It should be stored somewhere in the server. Okay, in internet. Okay, and this mic should be Wi-Fi enabled. You connect this mic to the internet. So as I speak, what this mic will do is, it'll get this word, it'll convert it into text. After converting it, it has to compare. It'll go to ping, it'll go to the server, check whether this particular word is there or not. If it is there, it will filter out. If it's not there, it'll send it. Now what you can call this mic as?
Smart mic.
Smart mic. So it starts to think. It's taking decisions now. And how was this possible? How is this possible? Only through connectivity and what?
Process.
And the data. And the data. These two things. Data and the connectivity. These two things are really important. Only these two things can give intelligence to a system. That's what is IoT is all about. You don't want to control a light here from US. You don't want to do that. It can do that, but still you don't. That's not the concern. That's not the objective. IoT is all about intelligence. And intelligence can be given only through networking, connectivity, and this data set. Okay? Fine. And what in real time are we having now? What is giving some examples of IoT systems we have present? Your mobile. Okay? How does it work? What does it do? What does it do? What is intelligent in that? You Google. Okay, which is the most intelligent system in the world now?
Watson.
Artificial intelligence system. What is it?
Watson.
Watson. You can call us Google.
Okay.
Google is the most intelligent system in the world. Why is Google so powerful? Why are they more intelligent compared to other things?
Because they have
data sets.
Yeah. Someone asked this question some few days back. I saw this post in FB. You know, someone's asking this. A guy was asking like, why can't Apple let everything free? Like Google is giving everything for free, right? Google is giving most of the things for free. Why Apple is not doing that? This guy was asking this question. And the answer was like this. For Apple, the product is their iPad, iPhone, or whatever they have. For Google, the product is us. Who's the product?
Users.
We are the product. Google makes use of us. Our data gives intelligence to their system. If there's no our data, so indirectly we are working for Google without getting even paid. So we are all Google employees. Right?
We are getting paid through the services, right?
Yeah, we are getting paid through services, but not everyone. Okay, so you have seen this movie Ex Machina. I used to show this clip to people who come for my workshop. Have you seen this movie Ex Machina? Ex Machina? Okay, go and watch it if you possible. Now there's a scene where he's this guy. Okay, the movie is about an AI robot. Okay, the creator of it is the owner of a search engine too. Okay, the creator of the robot, he's the owner of a search engine. Just like Google. That's the most used search engine in the movie. What he does, he creates a robot. Instead of giving lines and lines of codes to give intelligence to this robot, he just connects this robot to Google, to his search engine. Okay, let me use the word Google, okay? Don't confuse. So what he'll do is, he'll create this robot. He won't use any specific software for intelligence. All he'll do is, he'll give this robot the Google capacity. And in a scene, he says this, I hack all the mobile phones, the microphones and the camera from all over the world. I read up all those data to my search engines. Now these data, he uses this word, very, very good sentence. He says like this, data is like striking oil when there's no combustion engine available. Data at present is like striking oil when there's no combustion engine available. What does it mean? You have oil in your hand, there's no combustion engines available, what do you do with it? You won't do anything. So you won't know how to use that. So what he says after that, he says like this. People nowadays, what they use this data to monetize. Like for advertisements, right? You see all these Facebook ads and Amazon ads. You go shop on Amazon, you come back to Facebook, you'll see whatever you shopped on the sponsored ads. They use your preferences in your Facebook. They track you. Okay? They keep track of whatever you do. So all this tracking is used for monetizing. But what this guy did in the movie, he used all this data to keep intelligence to his system. Okay, to his robot. So, okay, the movie ends like this. It fools him, it escapes from the facility, that's how the movie ends. Okay, it becomes so intelligent. Okay, when people speak about IoT, they always ask this, is it good or bad? Okay, people always used to ask this question. Because whatever movie which depicts IoT or intelligence, in every movie, the intelligence system is a villain. Right? You go and watch this Avengers movie, Age of Ultron. Ultron is a villain. He's not a good guy. Or you take Terminator, Genesis, Skynet, or Genesis is a villain again. You watch Transcendence?
Yes.
Okay, you watch Transcendence. In Transcendence, it's not a villain, but humans, you know. Humans, you know, they think of it as a villain, they destroy it. So, in most of the movies, it shows how IoT will be, or intelligence will be, they depict it as something bad. See.
Are you saying artificial intelligence and IoT are same?
They can't, see, artificial intelligence and IoT have to exist, they have to coexist. There's an article recently which says that IoT can't exist without artificial intelligence, or otherwise, I don't know.
It can't go beyond its defined sets, IoT. That's where it goes in this.
Yeah, see, what I will tell is artificial intelligence is a product of IoT. That's what I will say. Because when you connect things together, you get this intelligence. Because things start to think, they speak to each other. Likewise, you have smart fridges coming up. Okay, what does the fridge does? Our fridge nowadays, they cool things, that's it. But smart fridges, they'll be connected to the internet. They'll be connected to your Amazon account. Or they'll be connected to your some online account. Or your bank account. Let's say you take a milk packet from your fridge. Your fridge will come to know that milk packet is taken. And it'll place the order automatically. Yeah. Now this is intelligence. And this intelligence comes through connectivity. Are getting it? So IoT is going to be a real fascinating thing coming up. So make sure every one of us have some hand on it. Okay? And these meetings, you know, they really pave the way for getting us into it. Okay, you should thank the IoT Geeks community. Okay, I'm proud I'm a part of it. Okay. But I often come, you know, I don't come often because I have other work, so Satya and other people, they take care of it. Thanks to them. Okay, so that's it. You want to speak something on IoT, you can just share your things. See, IoT is coming up in all the movies. You can speak about movies, I guess. That will be more exciting. Any other movies where
I couldn't remember the name of the movie exactly, but the lead character will fall in love with the artificial intelligence system. It's just a system who interacts with the guy who works in a publishing department writing letters, who will be even left out parents or something like that. So they use the artificial intelligence system to interact with him. So currently he falls in love with that system, and one day all the AI system actually they would take it out of the people, and that guy goes into depression and they suicide themselves they are not able to deal with that depression without that kind of system. So they finally end up suiciding themselves.
Okay, when did this movie came?
Around like 2010 or whatever. Scarlett Johansson was also a lead character.
Maybe what is? You have seen this Tesla cars recently, right? Tesla cars, they are intelligent because because it's connected. You know, very recently there was a car crash, you must have seen. You know, the Tesla car was driving, it was going, and the two cars in front of it were about to crash. This car stopped predicting it's going to crash. This car stopped 2 seconds before, predicting what is going to happen. Now how can this be done? All cars will be tracked. You know, they all cars track in the sense, the speed will be monitored, and the distance between two cars will be monitored. So there'll be an algorithm in the server side which will be like this. See, I'm not giving you the exact thing. It might be like this. So the algorithm might be like this. It's like, let's say a car approaches a particular car at a particular speed, it'll crash. This is the algorithm. Are you getting it? If a car approaches another car with a particular distance, it will crash, it will end up in crashing. So this will be an algorithm in the server side. Now using this algorithm, it predicted, okay, that the two cars in front of it will go into the crash, you stop this one. Let's say there is no connectivity, there is no internet. That's it. This will go on. So connectivity is really important. That's why I used to say IoT and artificial intelligence, they have to coexist. Okay, both of them have to, you know, get the power of other one. Okay, and even this, there was another incident with Tesla. A man was saved after having a heart attack. He was driving and he had a heart attack. Before laying down, he switched on the semi-automatic mode, I guess. And he laid down. Now this car, it understood this driver is having some problem. It automatically searched for the nearby hospital. It took the car and stood in front of the hospital. That's it. He got saved. So someone, people came and just had a look at inside the car. A man was lying down and he was saved. Fine. So what is the inference from my speech? IoT is important, so make sure everyone has a hand on it. Okay? Thank you.